أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الخلق والمرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، فعلمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا، وزدنا علما، وأرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه، واجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه، وأدخلنا برحمتك في عبادك الصالحين، آمين. One time the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was sitting at his home with his servant Thawban radiyallahu anhu. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he went outside for some issues he wants to make. So he was away from home for a couple of hours, and then he came back. He found Thawban radiyallahu anhu crying. He asked him, "Oh my dear Thawban, why are you crying?" He said, "Ya Rasulullah, I missed you." The Prophet ﷺ said, "It was just a short time I was away from you." He said, "Yes, Ya Rasulullah, but indeed I was thinking about Al-Jannah, where you are going to be in Jannah and where I am going to be in Jannah. There will be a big difference. You will be in the high top and I will be somewhere down. So I thought, I'm not going to see you there anymore. And that's why I cried. I cannot hold myself not to see you anymore." Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this verse. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ أولئك مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا. Those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His messengers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put them together with the prophets and الصديقين and الشهداء والصالحين. So Thawban smiled and he said, "Ya Rasulullah, I will be with you there. May Allah make us, all of us, be with him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." Thawban, he missed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for a couple of hours, and he missed him until he cried. How much we miss you, Ya Rasulullah. We never saw you. But we loved you much. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the last halqa I talked about the year of sadness in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he missed his uncle Abu Talib and his beloved wife Khadija radiyallahu anha. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he missed Khadija so much, and he used to cry for her absence radiyallahu anha. Until one time, one lady, she went to see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and she found him so sad. Then she said, Ya Rasulallah, why don't you get married another time? The Prophet ﷺ, he married Sayyida Khadija when he was 25 years old. And when she died, he was 50 years old. So the Prophet ﷺ, he said to her, after 25 years of marriage, successful marriage, is there anyone left after Khadija? There is no one. There is no one. And then he said, she was the mother of my children, and she was the lord of my house. Look to this title which the Prophet ﷺ gave to her. She was the lord of my house, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And she supported me whenever all people left me behind. And she believed in me where the people, they say I am a liar. And she stayed with me in the darkest time where the people abandoned me, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When he used to slaughter any animal, for example, goat or something, he used, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to take a share from that mutton, from that meat. And Aisha is asking, for whom you are saving this portion? He said, this is for the friends of Khadija, radiyallahu anha. He never forget about Khadija, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So it was a sad time for the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, after Khadija passed away. But indeed, we have to think about it, why this happened and why at this time. It was really very critical time. After the boycott is over and the Muslimin were so weak and they need the support, and the Prophet ﷺ, he needs the support still. So the death of his uncle gave him a really hard time to face Quraysh. And the death of his beloved wife also gave him a very hard time to accommodate all the stress which he found outside. So someone will ask, why it was chosen at this time for them both together to leave? And in the seerah, they said there is a three narrations that the time between Abu Talib death and Khadija, they said some of the narrations, they said 3 days, some narration they said 1 week, some narration they said 1 month. But even though it was really a short time, so why it happened at this moment? Exactly, there was a message not only for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but for every one of us. Who is for us there? He is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the message. We have to depend only on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is what is called at-tawakkul ala Allah. We have to depend and build our plans based on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Make him satisfied and pleased from us subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a big lesson that everyone whom you imagine that he gonna support you, they gonna disappear at any time and suddenly, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will be there always for you. He will be there always for you, always. And one very important message. You know, even you have your best friend, even you have someone who is really in power, but imagine every time you need help, you go to him. Every time you need support, you go to him. At the end, he will get bored from you. He will say, you don't have anybody else than me? Go find somebody else. Or sometimes you try to call him, he's not there, he's not available, he's busy. Sometimes you try to call him, there is no network, his phone is changed. Sometimes he say, oh, I'm not able to do this, I'm busy. But when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is always there, always. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is listening to you, either you say it or even you didn't say it. You didn't. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling about Zakariya alayhi salam. He said, إِذْ نَادَ رَبَّهُ نِدَاءً خَفِيًّا. What that means? No one listened to what he's saying. No one. خَفِيَّة. Even his wife, which she was beside him, she didn't listen. She didn't listen. Look to that woman. She came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Aisha said, that lady, she came to complain about her husband. And she sit with the Prophet ﷺ on the other corner of the room. The house of Aisha was only one room. It wasn't a mansion. It wasn't a house. It was one room. So she sit with the Prophet ﷺ, whispering to him about her husband. When he said, you are for me like my mother. And this one is kind of qasam, that she's haram on him from now on, like his mother. So she complained, Ya Rasulullah, after all this age, I become old. Now he abandoned me. Now I cannot support. I have a children to take care. If I leave the children for him, they're gonna starve and they're gonna be lost. And I cannot manage to feed the children. What shall I do, Ya Rasulullah? Aisha said, by Allah, I was sitting with her in the same room. I didn't hear what she was saying to the Prophet, but Allah heard, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he revealed the Quran for this purpose. Allah is listening. Even you didn't say it, he knows what you want. Even it is in your heart, even it is in your thoughts, but he's listening, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah is giving us a lesson from this incident, that you depend on Allah. Put all your expectations and plans based on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the one who can defend and support you. He's the one who can change your life within seconds. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. Means, even you plan to do something, even you have an idea about things, but Allah, in order to give you a lesson that it comes from Him, He will never make it from your way. He will make it for you from a different way, because that is His way, which He see that is better for you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that was the lesson. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he didn't make the sad moments to disturb his life and to stop him from making da'wah, from going forward. So he said, I have to use this in order to keep going. And then he said, now Quraysh is fighting me, is resisting my da'wah. They don't want this da'wah to keep going. I will not stop here. Then he said to his Mawla Zayd ibn Haritha radiyallahu anhu, he said, oh Zayd, I decided to go to At-Ta'if to get support from them. So why he chose At-Ta'if sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Actually, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in one verse, وَقَالُوا لَوْلَا أُنزِلَ هَذَا لَوْلَا نُزِّلَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنُ عَلَى رَجُلٍ مِّنَ الْقَرْيَتَيْنِ عَظِيمٍ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here is explaining to us that these two cities were the biggest power in the Arab land, Mecca, then At-Ta'if. So the second power in the Arab lands was At-Ta'if. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he chosen At-Ta'if. He wants a really good power to support him and to give him the chance to call people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from outside Mecca. Because Mecca, after all these years, now it's been 10 years. 10 years of da'wah. And Quraysh is still resisting and not allowing him to go outside to make the da'wah. So Zayd said to him, Ya Rasulullah, how can we go? Shall we bring some camels or horses? He said, no. If we do this, Quraysh will know that we are going outside to ask help. So I don't want Quraysh to know that we are seeking help from outside Mecca. Then he said, then what, Ya Rasulullah? Then the Prophet ﷺ said, we'll go walking. Walking, Ya Rasulullah. Walking. 50 years old, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And after the boycott, everyone become weak, even the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes, we'll go walking. And he chose Zayd to be with him because Zayd raised in his house. And he was considered as adopted son, radiyallahu anhu. So no one from Quraysh will recognize that they are going outside. So they will know, oh, they are going to some close place, maybe to visit someone close. So they start the travel towards At-Ta'if, 80 kilometers. So he make it within 4 days. 4 days of walking, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, until he reach At-Ta'if. And At-Ta'if was a high elevated, it was in the mountains, 5,000 feet high. So he used to walk all this distance and to climb the mountains, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when he reached to At-Ta'if, he didn't go here and there. He was focused. He knows what he wants. He went direct to the leaders of Bani Thaqif. That is the tribe name, Bani Thaqif. So the leaders were three sons, three brothers. They are the brothers of Amr ibn Umayr ibn Auf. They are the sons of Amr ibn Umayr ibn Auf. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam introduce Islam and introduce himself, and he told them, I need your support. to help me to go outside Mecca, to start calling people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is their response? So the first one, he said, didn't Allah find somebody else better than you? لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. And then the second one, he said, I'm not going to talk with you. If you are really telling the truth that you are a prophet, so you are higher than me, I will not speak with you. And if you are a liar, so you are lower than me, I will not speak with you. So he turned his face. And the third one, he said, by Allah, if I see you holding the carpet of Al-Kaaba, I will never believe you. So it was blocked. So the Prophet ﷺ said to them, so if you don't believe in me and you don't want to help me, at least don't tell Quraysh that I came to you. Because if they tell Quraysh that he came, so Quraysh now become more aggressive and more defensive, and they can make it really hard decision to kill the Prophet ﷺ. So they said, by Allah, we'll send someone now to tell Quraysh. And they call one man and they told him, go to Mecca and tell the people of Quraysh that Muhammad came asking help and support from us against Quraysh. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, okay, then let me go back in peace. They said, by Allah, we'll not let you leave in peace. And they call their children and they ask them to stone the Prophet ﷺ. So the Prophet ﷺ start walking away after he hear this, while the children, they were following him ﷺ with the stones. And Zayd ibn Haritha tried to cover and protect the Prophet ﷺ from the stones from all directions, but won't help much. So the Prophet ﷺ, his feet become injured and he was bleeding. They continue running away until they reach one garden nearby at Ta'if. That one for Shayba ibn Rabi'ah and his brother Amr ibn Rabi'ah. So they went inside the garden to avoid the stones until this chaos end. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam stand and pray two rak'ah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he make this dua. He said, O Allah, I complain to you my weakness. He didn't complain about the people. He didn't complain that he was stoned. He said, O Allah, I complain to you my weakness and the shortage of my resources. But if you are not mad from me, I don't mind what happens to me. I don't mind. If you are not mad from me, I don't mind. But indeed, I prefer your peace and forgiveness. O Allah, you are the Lord of the weak and the humble people. And I am a weak. I seek refuge with your face. The one which is shining with light and changed the darkness of universe into light, not to abandon me. That is the dua. And this is a really very powerful dua if you memorize it. So after the Prophet ﷺ finished the dua and finished his prayers, those two brothers, Amru and Shaybah, both, they saw the Prophet bleeding, so they felt so passionate. So they sent their servant with some grape to give to the Prophet ﷺ. So that servant came with the grapes to the Prophet ﷺ. And he said, this is from the owners of this garden to you. Then the Prophet ﷺ take one piece and he said loudly, Bismillah, and he eat it. That servant, he said, pardon me, the people of this country, they are not saying the words you are saying. So from where you got this? So he was so curious, from where you got this? Then the Prophet ﷺ said, what is your name, my son? He said, my name is Addas. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, from which country you are, Addas? From where you are? He said, I am from Nineveh in Iraq. The Prophet ﷺ said, that is the country, that is the city of Al-Abdus Salih, the humble man, Yunus ibn Matta, Yunus alayhi salam. Then Addas opened his eyes. Do you know Yunus? He said, yes, he is my brother. And he was a prophet, and I am a prophet of Allah too. Then Addas, he leaned down to the feet of the Prophet ﷺ, and he kissed him and he announced the shahada. Subhanallah. Without any call. The Prophet ﷺ wanted the leaders of Thaqif, but Allah gave him Addas. It's not always the way you want. Allah is giving you something better. Subhanallah. And then the Prophet ﷺ continue his travel until he reach somewhere beside the mountain of Mina, the area of Mina. Aisha radiallahu anha, one time she asked the Prophet ﷺ, Ya Rasulullah, which was the hardest time for you from your people? Is it the day of Uhud? We all know what the Prophet ﷺ faced in the day of Uhud. He said, no, it was that time when I went to At-Ta'if. That was the hardest time ever in the life of the Prophet ﷺ. That was when I went to At-Ta'if. And then I flee away. I don't know where to go until I found myself in that place nearby the area of Mina. I don't know where to go. He felt lost, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And then suddenly I saw like a cloud on the top of my head. So I raised my head. I saw my brother Jibreel alayhi salam. And there was another angel with him. So Jibreel came to me and he said, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah has heard what you said to your people, and he heard what the people they replied to you, and he sent with me the angel of the mountains to serve you. So ask him what do you want to do with those people. Then the angel came to the Prophet and he said, As-salamu alayka ya Rasulallah. If you like, you instruct me. I'm gonna smash the people of At-Ta'if between the mountains of At-Ta'if. He said, no, my brother, no. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to guide them or guide their children if they don't. No. That was the hardest time. The Prophet ﷺ chose peace. He didn't choose revenge. There is no revenge in Islam. He didn't choose to revenge from those who hurt him, who make this was the worst moment in his life. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was totally broke from them, totally upset, until he felt lost. He don't know where to go. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, no, my brother. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide them, or at least will guide their children, and they will be Muslimin. So he didn't accept to revenge. He didn't accept to do something weird, because what the angel said to him, he said, Allah said the truth when he named you Ra'ufun Rahim. لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم صلى الله عليه وسلم. That is the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. رؤوف رحيم. والحمد لله رب العالمين. اللهم اجمعنا على ما يرضيك واجعلنا من المتحابين فيك. اللهم اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مباركا مرحوما، وتفرقنا من بعده معصوما، ولا تجعل منا ولا فينا شقيا ولا محروما. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا، وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم إنا نسألك صحبة حبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم ربنا قد حرمنا صحبته في الدنيا، فلا تحرمنا إياها في الآخرة يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم اجبر كسرنا وارحم ضعفنا، وتولى أمرنا، ولا تسلط علينا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا. اللهم لا تجعل لنا في مقامنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا همّا إلا فرجته، ولا عيبا إلا سترته، ولا مريضا لنا إلا شافيته وعافيته، ولا حاجة لنا من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة إلا يسرتها وقضيتها. يا قاضي الحاجات، يا مجيب الدعوات، اللهم بدل سيئاتنا حسنات، اللهم بدل سيئاتنا حسنات، اللهم بدل سيئاتنا حسنات. اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين، واعلي بفضلك راية الحق والدين. اللهم هيئ لهذه الأمة قادة صالحين وأئمة عاملين، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين، واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. اللهم يا أرحم الراحمين، ارزقنا من خير الدنيا والآخرة، ومن كل خير سألك منه نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وأعذنا من كل شر استعاذك منه نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم إنا نسألك قبل الموت توبة، وعند الموت شهادة، وبعد الموت راحة وسعادة يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. ربنا آمنا بما أنزلت واتبعنا الرسول فاكتبنا مع الشاهدين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. سبحانك.